there was a dreadful old man named Ebenezer Scrooge. Oh, he was a squeezing, wrenching, grasping, clutching old sinner. Scrooge had been in partnership for many years with Jacob Marley, so his firm was known as Scrooge and Marley. But Marley had been dead for 7 years. Yes, Marley was dead, dead as a doornail. And old Scrooge lived alone and disliked everybody. He had a clerk in his office named Bob Cratchit, and he only paid the poor fellow, who had a wife and 4 children, a wage that scarcely fed him. The meager office that Cratchit sat in was like a cold, dismal little cell. When Cratchit stopped to warm his hands over the burnt-out coal, Scrooge looked up over his glasses and said,
"Cratchit, get on with your work."
Christmas Eve, and into the office of Scrooge and Marley popped Scrooge's nephew, Fred.
A Merry Christmas, Uncle. God save you.
Humbug.
Some
fellow
Christmas smith. Bah! Humbug!
What's Christmas time to you but a time for paying bills without money? A time for finding yourself a year older, not an hour richer.
Humbug.
Christmas a humbug, Uncle? You don't mean that, I'm sure.
I do. Merry Christmas. What right have you to be merry? You're poor enough.
Oh, come now, what right have you to be dismal? You're rich enough.
That's humbug.
Cross, Uncle.
What else can I be when I live in such a world of fools as this? If I could work my will, every idiot who goes about with Merry Christmas on his lips would be boiled with his own pudding and buried with a stick of holly through his heart.
Oh, Uncle.
Keep Christmas in your own way and let me keep it in mine.
But you don't keep it.
Much good may it do you.
Uncle. Christmas is the only time I know of in the long calendar of the year when men and women seem by one consent to open their hearts freely. And therefore, Uncle, although it has never put a scrap of gold or silver in my pocket, I believe that it has done me good and will do me good.
Humbug.
Oh, I'm sorry with all my heart to find you so determined.
Good afternoon.
Don't be angry, Uncle.
Good afternoon.
Don't be angry, Uncle. Come, dine with us tomorrow.
Good afternoon.
Oh, I'm sorry with all my heart to find you so determined.
Good afternoon.
Bah! Humbug!
So, a Merry Christmas, Uncle.
Good afternoon.
And a Happy New Year.
Good afternoon.
Another word out of you, Cratchit, and you'll keep your Christmas by losing your situation.
Thank you.
Humbug! Chris Kringle. Old Saint Hypocrite.
Hold it, Jingle. Humbug soup. Humbug nose. Hand out for everybody, everywhere he goes. Calculated list. Things to give away. So he'll make a profit on Christmas Day. Humbug. Humbug!
Scrooge and Marley, I believe. Do I have the honor of addressing Mr. Scrooge or Mr. Marley?
Marley's been dead these 7 years. He died 7 years ago this very night. That's Marley.
We have no doubt his liberality is well represented by his surviving partner. We are collecting for the poor.
As is the custom at this Christmas season.
What can we put you down for, Mr. Scrooge?
Nothing.
You wish to be anonymous?
I wish to be left alone.
Should we not at this time of the year make provision for the poor and the destitute?
Are there no prisons?
Plenty.
No workhouses?
Plenty.
No poorhouses?
Plenty.
I help to support these establishments. They cost enough. Those who are badly off must go there.
Many can't. And many would rather die.
Rather die, they'd better do it. Decrease the surplus population. It's enough for man to understand his own business and not interfere with other people's.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Jim.
Good afternoon.
Indeed, good afternoon.
It's shutting up time, sir.
Yes.
And, sir, I was wondering whether you would allow me the day off. That is, if it's convenient, sir.
It's not convenient, and it's not fair. If I were to stop half a crown for it, you'd think yourself very ill-used, wouldn't you? And yet you don't think me ill-used when I pay a day's wages for no work.
But it's Christmas only once a year, sir.
Yeah. Christmas. Nothing but a poor excuse to pick a man's pocket every December the 25th. Yeah.
May I have tomorrow off, sir?
I suppose you must. But be here all the earlier the next morning.
I will, sir. I will indeed, sir. Thank you, sir.
Late that evening, Scrooge left his dreary office and went home to his dismal chambers. Chambers once occupied by his dear partner, Marley. It was dark, and when he reached the house, he was amazed to notice...
Christmas. Humbug.
quite satisfied, he locked the door, took off his coat, put on his dressing jacket and his pointed nightcap, and sat down before the fire to take his meager gruel. As he sat looking at the low fire, he suddenly realized...
Humbug! Humbug! Don't believe it. Rubbish. What's that? Who's there? Who is it? Who is it?
Suddenly, right through the wall, and then, behold, inside the room, Scrooge saw before his very eyes...
Marley! What do you want with me?
But...
Who are you?
I was your partner, Jacob Marley. Don't you believe me?
I don't.
What evidence would you have of my reality beyond that of your own senses?
Oh, because the little thing affects the senses. Disorder of the stomach makes them cheat. You may be an undigested bit of beef, a blot of mustard, a crumb of cheese, a fragment of an underdone potato.
You will be haunted by three spirits.
Huh?
Without their visit, you cannot hope to shun the path I tread. Expect the first tomorrow when the bell tolls one. Expect the second on the next night at the same hour. The third upon the next night when the last stroke of 12 has ceased to vibrate. Look to see me no more and remember what has passed between us.
About you, whatever you are.
Oh,
oh, mercy! Your shackles. Tell me why.
They were the chain I forged in life. I made it link by link and yard by yard. Is it pattern strange to you?
Be comforting me, Jacob.
I've none to give that neither, Scrooge. In life, my spirit never rose beyond the narrow limits of our many changing poles, and weary journeys lie before me. Hear me, my time is nearly gone.
I will, But don't be hard on me, Jacob.
I'm here tonight to warn you that you've yet a chance and hope of escaping my fate, Ebenezer.
You always were a good friend to me. Thank you.
Hear what I say. You will be haunted by three spirits.
Huh?
Without their visit, you cannot hope to shun the path I tread. To warn you that you've yet a chance and hope of escaping my fate, Heaven.
You always were a good friend to me. Thank you. Why do spirits walk the earth, and why do they come to me? When that bell tolls one, humbug. The hour itself and nothing else.
Suddenly a light flashed up in the room,
and the first of the promised spirit visitors stood before.
Are you the spirit whose coming was foretold?
I am.
Who and what are you?
I am the ghost of Christmas Town.
Long past? Long past?
No, your past.
Well, what brings you here?
Your welfare.
Oh, I'm much obliged for keeping an old man from his sleep.
Your recommendation, then. Take ease. Rise and walk with me.
But...
That is not what I meant.
Oh, Ebenezer, I've seen your nobler aspirations fall off one by one. You're changed. You no longer need me.
Have I ever said so?
In words, never.
No, I don't want to see it. Show me no more. Humbug. Humbug. Don't believe it.
Ebenezer Scrooge.
Yes?
Come in and know me better, man.
What do you want from me? What have you done to my room here? This is my room. But it's undergone a strange transformation. This holly and mistletoe... What does it mean, and who are you?
I am the ghost of Christmas present. Come closer. Fear me not.
Spirit, conduct me where you will. Tonight, if you have aught to teach me, let me profit by it.
Touch my robe.
Gladly. The man I was. I'll not be the man I must have been.
Then the spirit vanished, and a new and different figure appeared. Silently toward him. It was shrouded in a deep black garment, which left nothing of it visible save one outstretched hand. This was the third and last of his ghostly visitors. Scrooge braced himself and said,
Yes, I know. You're the ghost of Christmas yet to come. I fear you more than any specter I've seen. But I know your purpose is to do me good. I'm prepared to bear you company. Lead on, spirits. Lead on.
The phantom moved, and Scrooge followed. And at length, the ghost of Christmas yet to come brought him to a neglected gravestone.
What's this? These awful weeds. I can hardly see. Whose name's written on this crumbling stone? Ebenezer Scrooge. Me. Oh, no, Spirit, no, no. Spirit, hear me. I'm not the man I was. I'll not be the man I must have been. Good Spirit, pity me. Assure me I may yet change these shadows you've shown me by an altered light. I'll honor Christmas in my heart and try to keep it all the year. Oh, tell me I may wipe off the writing of this terrible stone.
In his agony, he caught the spectral hand, but the spirit repulsed him. As Scrooge held up his hands in a last prayer to have his fate reversed, he saw an alteration in the phantom shape. It began to shrink. It collapsed. And then...
This room, my own room. Oh, bless it all. I live the past, the present, and the future. I will. The spirits of all three shall strive within me. Oh, Jacob Marley, heaven and the Christmas time be praised for this. I say it on my knees, old Jacob, on my knees. I'm as light as a feather. I'm happy as an angel. I'm merry as a schoolboy.
Afternoon, he arrived at his nephew's house.
Is your master at home, my dear?
Yes, sir.
Where is he, my love?
Why, bless my soul, who's that?
It's I, your Uncle Scrooge. I've come to dinner.
For Scrooge greeted everyone with a delightful smile and...
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas, Mr. Scrooge!
And Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas!
Scrooge was better than his word. He did it all and more. He became as good a friend, as good a master, and as good a man as the good old city knew, or any other good old city in the good old world. He had no further experience with spirits, but lived a happy life ever afterward. And it was always said of him that he knew how to keep Christmas well, if anybody did.
Oh, it's only once a year, sir. It shall not be repeated. I was making rather merry yesterday, sir.
Now, I'll tell you what, my friend. I'm not going to stand this sort of thing any longer. And therefore, I'm about to raise your salary.
Oh,
A Merry Christmas, Bob.
Oh, a Merry Christmas to you.
A Merrier Christmas, Bob, my good fellow, than I've given you for many a year. I'm as light as a feather. I'm happy as an angel. I'm merry as a schoolboy. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Mr. Scrooge.
A Merry Christmas. God bless us, everyone.